going to say very much this evening. No doubt you'll welcome that, because I know you've come to see your children. And it is rather a long program this evening, so quicker we can start with that. I do feel, though, that I cannot let it pass without my thanking all the people that are responsible for our concert this evening. So if you would just excuse me while I run through the people who have contributed. And I would like to start with you, because without your assistance, of course, we could not possibly run the sort of concert that we do. I'm sorry that we had to pack you together. I could have got almost half as many in again from the applications that we had. And so I do hope you will excuse the crowding, the somewhat crowding that we do here, but we have managed to get 240 of you in this evening, believe it or not. From time to time, we shall let you stand up and stretch your legs, and some of this will have to be a little impromptu, so I don't know whether the evening people are there listening. If not, then they may leave you sitting there forever, but I hope from time to time they will remember to come and say, all right, you can stretch your legs now, so be patient, you'll certainly get one at the end. Now, saying thank you to you, not only for the costuming that you've done, but also for all the other support you've given me throughout the year. It's always nice to have Christmas come along so that I can do just that. In fact, it would be very difficult, wouldn't it, to imagine a year without a Christmas. And likewise, I think now it would be very difficult also to imagine Forres without his Christmas concerts. And with the sort of support you give me, I'm sure that will always go on. Also, with the support that I've had from the teachers, who have been very, very happy and cheerful in spite of all the extra work that they have to do at this time. And it is a lot. Not only do they have to get the concerts ready, but they also have to plan the costumes and then all the decorations and so on to be done. And that brings me to thanking two people for the decorations, Miss Withers and Mrs. Wollstonecombe, who have organised the decorations, certainly in the areas that you've seen this evening. They've worked very hard for that. I'd like to thank all the teachers for the efforts they've put in, and my welfare helpers, who have an awful lot of extra work thrust upon them at this time. I'd like especially to thank my wife, who has to do a great deal of ordering and administrative work in her own time at this time of the year, and to say to the children, but she loves Christmas as much as I do, and as much, I think, as you do too, and so she does that very cheerfully. I must thank my caretaker, who I haven't known myself since I appointed him. You know, he does all the jobs now that I used to have to do or find time to do, and he's always up and down ladders and carrying things about. He's been a great help to me today, you know, getting all, just the organisation of getting all the chairs in and squashing you in here. And last of all, I'd like to thank two people who do continue to give me tremendous support within the school. That is my senior teacher, Mrs. Schulters, who also would not know what to do with herself without Christmas, I think. And my deputy head, Mr. Martin, who told me I've got to come out here and talk tonight. I said, do you think I really need to? Because, you know, we've got to keep the thing as short as possible. And he said, well, you know, it does give the right sort of atmosphere, which made me feel very cheerful. Thank you very much for all you, Mr. Martin. And he reminded me, too, that when he first came 2 years ago, when he came to a concert then, I think he came a little late, and everybody was practicing doing this. So I think we'll start again by practicing doing this. Can we please? I'm not going to say anymore. The children are ready to do their stuff. But from time to time, you'll get plenty of opportunity to keep the blood circulating that way. Don't be shy. You see, they love to be clapped, and they love you to laugh at them. So you'll know when to do it, because I shall start you off. But don't leave me doing it on my own, will you? Sit back and enjoy yourself.
Evening school. I'll ring again.
somebody do something, please?
Now, where those children got to? Home girl, Alex!
Coming, Mr. Wacker.
Yeah.
and they look very rich.
We don't do that. I can't help weeping.
Who said that?
Me, I'm called the Happy Pig. I've been on tour with poor people in my city. I feel anything but happy. I wish I could help them. Will you help me to do that?
Will it take long? I'm on my way to Egypt for the winter.
It will not take long. There is a poor woman and a beautiful dress for a rich lady. Her son is ill and she has no money to buy oranges to help him get well. Please take the ruby from my sword and fly it to her.
All right.
During the following night, the little swallow stayed with the happy prince. Each night she put her flying to Egypt and took strips of gold leaf with which the prince was covered to the poor people of the city, and every night it grew colder. By the time the happy prince had been stripped of all his gold, the little swallow had decided she could never leave him. Still the weather grew colder, and finally the little swallow spoke to the happy prince for the last time.
I'm sorry
I can serve you no longer,
but it's very cold and I'm sleepy. I'm glad at last you're going to Egypt.
But the little swallow knew that she was going to die and that she would never see Egypt. As she fluttered and died, the lead half of the statue cracked, and the prince no longer smiled. Meanwhile...